Hi, it's Lily Amanda for Portrait Creatives. In this video, we are going to talk about how do you stop presets, overrun your previous editing. I remember when I first used Lightroom preset, it was fun, but also frustrating. For example, after I shot event, usually there's hundreds of photos, right? And it's probably the same theme, just with different people. So I often have to apply the same editing to each and every photo for a batch. So that's when I find Lightroom really convenient. Just copy and paste all these settings. And then I start to explore with different presets. And I figure like, I can't use preset because you know, in an event, it's not always easy to get the right exposure. So I sometimes have two stop down or two stop higher. So when I go to editing, I have to tone them down if it's too bright. If it's too dark, I have to bring the brightness back. It happens a lot when shooting events. The exposure is always up and down, like two stop up, two stop down. It's all completely normal. So I will go into Lightroom to batch edit the exposures for each and every photo. For example, this batch, I might need to have to up 1.5 exposure, and I will do all of them together. And after that, I will apply a preset to give a style or feel to change the overall look to make it pop. But here's the problem. After I apply the preset, all the editing I did before was all set to the same as presets. It was all gone. I got really frustrated at one point. I don't use preset at all because with preset, it just overrun all the editing. And then I figure out how to do it without the presets ruin my editing. I'm going to show you how you can preserve the previous editing. And whenever you choose a different preset, apply to different preset, your previous editing will still be there. So let me take you into Lightroom. Well, now we are in Lightroom. This is a beautiful dancer, Luisa, and I'm going to do some editing. So I'm going to develop. So come to here just for demonstrate purpose. Okay. I'm not really doing the photo editing. So for example, I want to build up the exposure for this image, and I would just go here, exposure. And for example, I would just, let's say +1. Okay. And I want to reduce the contrast here. Right, so the image become flatter and less contrast. And then I'm going to apply for a preset to convert it to black and white. So let me show you. For example, I just click this black straight up, and guess what my setting is. So it's all changed to preset setting, right? And that's not what I want. So how am I going to overcome this problem? Let me just go to reset. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use a mask to apply any adjustment before I apply preset. Let me just click on this is a mask, and I will just use brush, for example. And because the setting I want to do is apply to all the images, so I will just brush all the image. I will just zoom out so I can just apply the mask setting to all the image. I make sure everything is selected for the mask. Okay, and then I start to do my adjustment. For example, what I did was 1, right? Okay, and just go to 1. And I want to decrease the contrast, just what I did before. Let me just go to 30 here. I apply all the editing, all the adjustment with a mask. And the thing is, when I create presets, I will use all the settings, but without mask. So think about that way. When people create presets, they will just make all the adjustments on the panel instead of use a mask to apply the adjustment. So when I use a mask to apply all the adjustment, it actually will not be affected by the preset. So when I apply to this preset, black straight up, it was not like before, the settings all changed. Instead, you have a look here. My adjustment's still here. And if I turn it off, you can see this eye here, turn it off. That means the adjustments are gone. And that will be overrun by the preset. Look at that. And that's after I did the adjustment. And so my adjustment's still there, still apply to the image, and that is so convenient to use. If I want to apply this, the mask, to multiple images, I can as well. Let me show you. I just have to right click on the thumbnail and then go to develop settings and then copy settings. And you come to this window, right? And you have here, look at this, masking. So I'm gonna uncheck everything. And I'm gonna check this one. So copy, and for example, this is also Luisa. I am going to paste develop setting and paste settings. And you see, that's exactly my setting. If I click on the mask, and you will see that was the setting I applied to the previous image. And now it's copy and paste to here. And then I can change to any preset I want without my previous settings being changed. It's really cool, right? It's just like how you get around things. And the software like Lightroom is so powerful, but there's always ways to do work. When you figure things out, how to work around in the software, it really make your life easier, okay? And you can also apply to several different images, okay? Develop settings and then paste. You can paste all of them, okay? I hope you enjoyed this tip, because for me, that was a huge discovery. After I learned this, it was so much easier for me to work with presets. And sometimes with event photos, I don't even have to go into Photoshop. It's just super, super easy and convenient. If you have any questions, leave in the comment below. I will try my best to answer your questions or even create a tutorial for you. If you find this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. We will be creating more helpful tutorials and we don't want you to miss out any. It's Lily Amanda for Portrait Creatives, and I'll see you in the next video.